Let's see a problem to determine rate law and rate constant. The following results have been obtained during the kinetic studies of the reaction, that is 2A plus 2B gives C plus D. He given this table, what he studied on this reaction. And he has determined the rate law and rate constant for the reaction. He conducting the experiment on this reaction, and result of that experiment he given in the form of table. These are the experiment number, experiment 1, 2, 3, 4. And these are the concentration of reactant A, and these are concentration of reactant B, and these are initial rate of formation of product D, that is rate of the reaction. Rate of formation of D is equal to rate of the reaction. Now see, let's understand this table. At experiment 1, he took concentration of A as 0.1, B as 0.1, and he found rate, initial rate as 6.0 into 10 to the power minus 3. Similarly, in the second experiment, he took concentration of A as 0.3 and concentration of B as 0.2. Then he found initial rate as 7.2 into 10 to the power minus 2. Similarly, he conducted the experiment 3 and 4. From this table, we have to find rate law and rate constant. So, given this reaction, what you have to find? Rate law and rate constant. To find rate law, see, rate law is, you can write like this, you know that rate equal to rate constant into concentration of A to the power X into concentration of B to the power Y. Here X is order with respect to A, and B, Y is order with respect to B. Now in order to find rate law, we have to find rate constant X and Y. So see how to find these two. From this table, you have to find either X or Y by looking at the experimental data. See, for that, see two experiment where concentration of one of the reactant is same. See here, in experiment 2 and experiment 3, concentration of the reactant 0.3 and concentration of the reactant A is 0.3 and 0.3. In both these two experiment, concentration of A is he kept as same, that is 0.3 and 0.3. But he varied the concentration of B, that is 0.2 to 0.4. See, in experiment 2 and 3, he kept concentration of A constant. He varied the concentration of B, that is 0.2 and 0.4. Now, see how much concentration of B is increased. Concentration of B is increased 2 times. 0.2 to 0.4 means concentration of B is increased 2 times. Now, you are keeping concentration of A constant and increasing the concentration of B 2 times. Then rate will increase with respect to B only, because you are keeping A constant. So rate will increase with respect to B only. See how much rate is increasing. Rate is increasing from 7.2 into 10 to the power minus 2 to 2.88 into 10 to the power minus 1. See at how much rate is increased, at what extent it is increased. To find that one, you divide this by this. So 2.88 into 10 to the power minus 1 by 1.72 into 10 to the power minus 2. When you divide this, you will get 4. So what? and we increase the concentration of B 2 times by keeping concentration of A constant, rate is increased 4 times. Rate is increased 4 times. See, for a second order reaction, you know that when you increase the concentration of the reactant 2 times, rate will increase this 4 times. See here, this is second order reaction because see order is 2. When you increase the concentration of A 2 times, 2 to the power 2, see rate will increase 4 times. So now what will you conclude now? See here also rate is increasing 4 times. So what you conclude now? Order with respect to B is second order reaction, that is 2. You are keeping concentration A same and increasing concentration 2 times, so rate is increasing 4 times. So order with respect to B is 2. So that is in my rate law, that is Y is 2. Now you have to find order with respect to A. Order with respect to A. Actually, we can find order with respect to A by calculation method. But let's calculate order with respect to A also by this. We can get the table only. Let's see in this table where the in two experiment where the concentration of one of the reactant is same. We have seen already this 0.3, 0.3. See here in experiment 1, 0.1 and in experiment 4, 0.1. That is concentration of B is same here in experiment 1 and experiment 4. But concentration of A is 0.1 to 0.4. See, concentration of A is increasing from 0.1 to 0.4. Your the concentration of B is same, 0.1 and 0.1. See, concentration of B is same, concentration of A is increasing from 0.1 to 0.4, that is 4 times. Concentration of A is increasing 4 times. See how much rate will increases. Now rate will increases with respect to A only, because concentration of A is only varying, concentration of B is kept constant. See how much rate will increases. Rate is increasing from 6.0 into 10 to the power minus 3 to 2.40 into 10 to the power minus 2. How much rate is increased when you increase the concentration of A 4 times and concentration of B is kept constant? For that, you divide this 2.40 into 10 to the power minus 2 by 6.0 into 10 to the power minus 3. You divide, you will get 4. See, when you increase the concentration of A 4 times, rate is increasing 4 times, keeping concentration of B as constant. This means what? See, for first order reaction, when you increase, this is first order reaction, order is 1. When you increase the concentration 4 times, so rate will increases 4 times. For first order reaction, when you increase the concentration 4 times, rate will increases 4 times. So what you now conclude? Now rate is order with respect to A. The order with respect to A is 1. That is first order reaction. See, don't confuse. Here, when you when concentration is doubled, rate is increasing 4 times. So that is second order reaction. Second order with respect to B. But here in this case, concentration is increasing 4 times, then rate is also increasing 4 times. So it is first order reaction. Now you can conclude order with respect to A is 2. I have written wrong here. It has to become A. Order with respect to A is 2. Now we have find out order with respect to A and order with respect to P. To find rate law, what you required now? You required rate constant. Let's see how to find it. For that, consider this rate law. Rate equal to k into concentration of A to the power x into concentration of B to the power y. In this, you know x, you know y. That is order with respect to B and order with respect to A. And you don't know k value. So for that, consider any one experiment. For that, I have taken fourth experiment. Take this fourth experiment reading. Fill concentration of A, that is 0.4, and concentration of B, that is 0.1. And rate is 2.40 into 10 to the power minus 2. Take this 2.40 into 10 to the power minus 2. And simultaneously simplify, keep this k as it is. 0.4 to the power 1 is 0.4, and 0.1 to the power 2 is 0.01. Now try to find out k. K equal to, take this whole term this side, that is 2.40 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 0.4 into 0.01. When you simplify this one, you will get k as 6. So rate constant k equal to 6 mole to the power minus 2 L square per minute. Why this mole to the power L square per minute unit? This is because this is third order reaction. This reaction is third order reaction. 2 plus 1 is 3. So this is third order reaction. For third order reaction, unit of rate constant is mole to the power minus 2 L square per minute. Since since time is given in minute, so it will become per minute. Now you find out value of k and x and y. Now you can find easily rate law. Rate law is k into a to the power 1 into a to the power 2 concentration. Fill here k. I missed. So fill this k equal to 6. Fill this k equal to 6. What is rate law? Rate law equal to 6 into concentration of a to the power 1 into concentration of b to the power 2. That's it, this problem. Thank you. Subscribe to my channel to get more videos. Like the video, share the video, and spread worldwide to help others.